For the next step in this process, you want to plan your finances. So this starts with your personal finances, which I don't discuss here, but you should really take a look at how much you yourself can invest and contribute to your business, because self-funding is going to be one of the primary ways that I recommend you fund your startup or fund your business. Now, I will say that you want to make sure that your quality of life is not going to take a detrimental hit. You're not going to, you know, not be able to eat or feed your kids or pay your rent to put money into your business. I mean, that is definitely up to you, but I don't recommend that because there are so many other resources. But for this section, we're going to talk about figuring out your finances. And the reason why this is the second step is because when you went through and did your market research and analysis, which you might still currently be doing, but when you do that, you might notice and find things that you also want to incorporate into your business that could be an additional cost. So that's why this is the second step. Again, this framework is entirely unique, but I'm trying to explain why it makes the most sense. So let's get into your financial planning. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to identify your one-time expenses. Now, these could be startup costs, but it's really just going to be things that you're going to pay the one time and you're not going to need to pay it again, or it's not going to be a reoccurring cost. Maybe you pay it once a year, and that could be potentially a recurring cost. It just depends on how much it fluctuates. I know that might have been a little confusing, so let's just jump right into it. So the first step in determining your startup costs or your funding cost is going to be to identify your one-time expenses. These are expenses that you will incur before the launch of your business, such as legal fees, equipment, inventory, and marketing. So this could be like filing your LLC. That's not a reoccurring cost, but you know, in your state, you might have to pay a fee, you know, every 3 years. So it is recurring, but in the sense of financial planning, and startup wise, you know, talking about starting up your small business, might not be considered a reoccurring cost. I know that is extremely confusing. But basically, we're going to work within the calendar year. So is this fee going to repeat itself within the year? I guess that's a better way of explaining it. So your startup costs, your one-time costs might include, you know, incorporation fees. Again, that's going to be like your LLC fees, legal fees, office or storefront lease. Now, there is usually an initial cost to sign that lease, but the rent won't go into this category. Equipment and supplies. Now, if you're renting that equipment, then there might be a cost there, but if you're buying it and it's yours, it's a one-time cost. Inventory. I don't really like to include inventory in startup costs, but maybe you're creating a product, so you have to go through the prototype phase and then actually purchase a minimum order quantity. So that would be a part of the startup cost. Marketing and advertising costs. Now, some of these things are write-offs, and the IRS does give you, I believe it's up to $5,000 of a tax deduction for startup costs. So make sure that you are documenting all the things that you're purchasing. Now you're going to talk about, website development costs. Now, if you're not going to create your website yourself and you're going to hire somebody to do it and you just maintain it, that'll be a one-time cost. Professional services such as accounting or consulting. Accounting will most likely be a reoccurring cost, but if you hire an accountant or a consultant to help you start your business, that's the one-time cost. And then you want to estimate your ongoing expenses, which is what we're going to get into in the next slide. So again, working within the one-year time frame, we're going to talk about our ongoing expenses. And these are going to be things that are going to be reoccurring, you know, on a regular basis. And that can be things such as your rent or mortgage payments, utilities, payroll and benefits, again, marketing and advertising if you have a marketing strategy in place, which we'll talk about that in a future lesson. Insurance premiums. When I started my fitness business, I had a $20 insurance premium every month. So that's going to be some of the things that you're going to include. Supplies and materials. This could be packaging supplies, things like that. Next is going to be professional services. And this could be like an annual thing. So again, if you have an accountant or CPA or someone who's doing your bookkeeping every month, that is what this is talking about. Not necessarily like filing your taxes. And then last is you're going to add everything up and you're going to calculate your startup costs. Okay, so now you're going to put everything together. So once you've identified your one-time and ongoing expenses, it's time to calculate your total startup costs. Basically, I recommend doing this for a 12-month time period, but depending on your business, you could potentially do this for the first 6 months. Basically, you're just going to add these two things together. So once you do that, and once you figure out how much money you can contribute, that difference is what you're going to have to seek somewhere else. And that can be through business loans, crowdfunding, Kickstarters, you know, things like that. So that is really what you're doing here. And now in the business plan template that I'm going to provide, there's going to be a little bit of a spreadsheet in there that identifies some of the startup costs. Now, startup costs and your financial planning is also something that's going to continuously change. So don't be surprised if you put your financial plan together in week one, and then by the time you get to week two and week three, you're adding stuff to it. And that's just because things happen and there's a lot of costs that you're not going to realize that you have to pay. And I'll give you a really good example. My first company was a security business. And when I first started that security business, I didn't know that I was going to have to pay a fee, basically, to an affiliate fee is what it's called, for some of the products that I was carrying. And that was extremely frustrating because it wasn't something that I incorporated, and I planned on funding this thing in myself. So I was like, oh, this is something else that I need to pay for. But you kind of have to roll with the punches here, which is why I also recommend that you put in about a 10 to 15% buffer. So if your startup costs are, let's say, $500, I recommend you kind of push that out to $600 maybe even a little bit more. Round it, if you can, to the nearest $1,000, because that'll, any little thing that comes your way, or if prices change, that's something you can accommodate for. And another example for this is, if you're looking to, let's say, do an e-commerce website like Shopify. Shopify is not very expensive every month. It's less than $50 a month, but it doesn't have all the features you might be looking for. So if you need to add these plugins or these apps into Shopify, then those are an additional cost. And I'll give you another example. For my fitness company, I wanted folks to be able to pre-order items that might be out of stock that we're waiting for. But the pre-order option is not on Shopify. I had to purchase this plugin, this additional feature, and it was another $20 a month, which is expensive. But when I analyzed it after the first few weeks, it's, you know, is it paying for itself, or do I need to incorporate these costs? But in the beginning, it was an upfront cost that I had to cover, which is why it's also really important for the ongoing cost. If anything fluctuates, if you find that you have to pay any additional fees, that you determine whether or not those things are making you money or if they're hurting your bottom line. If having these features is not necessary, or having these items is not necessary, you might want to consider, you know, cutting them out altogether.